or if you have, you will understand why it's the White Island and why it's magic. If not, just a few words to convince you that it's not maybe all that you've heard about. As far as the White Island is concerned, it was called the White Island by the Phoenicians some 5,000 years ago. And they called it the White Island because of what they found. And they were drawn here, they were great traders, and they sailed here and they found salt. Probably you saw the big salt flats as you came in to the airport. In those days, salt was more valuable than gold. The Romans paid their soldiers in salt. Hence we have the term, a man is worth his salt. They loaded up their ships, attempted to sail away, but found themselves next day drawn back here. They didn't understand it. They had a very crude form of compass, but what they didn't understand was the big rock you see over there standing alone. That is Esvedra, and it is the third strongest magnetic field on this planet. It is almost as strong as the Bermuda Triangle. So of course it will pull compasses, navigation systems. The Phoenicians didn't understand that, so they said it was magic. Hence, we have the magic White Island.
Jenna, I offer you all my love.
I offer you my strength.
I offer you my strength.
I offer you my weaknesses.
I offer you my weaknesses.
I offer you my support.
I offer you my support.
I offer you my loyalty.
I offer you my loyalty.
I offer you my all.
I offer you my all.
As long as we both show you.
As long as we both show you.
I offer you my love.
I offer you my strength.
I offer you my strength.
I offer you my weaknesses.
I offer you my weaknesses.
I offer you my support.
I offer you my support.
I offer you my loyalty.
I offer you my loyalty.
I offer you my all.
I offer you my all.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
Thank you. can change the way I feel about you. Thinking of this time flies, watching the beauty.
For the bride to speak, but I felt there was no better time or place to say a few words about Stuart. I'll try and hold it together. As most of you know, Stuart can drive me nuts. From being late to not showing up at all, forgetting to do things or leaving things behind, it's a daily occurrence. And then there's his metrosexual side, as my mum would say.
Oh, here we go.
Making the complex decision between a pair of black jeans and a pair of blue jeans. Picture messages giving me a live feed of his shopping trip. Or hogging the mirror and hairdryer, to name a few. But the reason I wanted to speak was not to tell of Stuart's mishaps, but to tell of his many more qualities. It was 2002, my last year in school, when a not so different looking Stuart would cruise along Loughton High Street on his moped during lunch break. He'd pull up and say, "Hello, Blondie, fancy a grit?" Fancy a grit? He'd treat me to a Tottenham sponge and escort me back to the school gate sealed with a kiss. I was hooked. A chicken heart or two later, we decided to make it official. In seriousness though, as we have grown older, my respect and love for him has grown too. And with both our 20s nearly said and done, I couldn't have asked to be treated any better. Aww. Stuart has always been there and supported me through every one of my life challenges and all my crazy ideas. He understands and completely accepts me for who I am more than I do myself. If I've had a bad day or I'm feeling down, he will give me the hug that I'm too proud to ask for or perhaps even deserve. It is so nice to know that every call and every day I know exactly what mood he'll be in, and that's a happy one. His patience, generosity and gentle nature make me feel like someone special every day, and I'm so grateful for that every day. So I'd like to raise a toast to Stuart's family for their continual selflessness and unconditional love that has no doubt made Stuart the man and now husband he is today. Thank you.
I have actually been fearing doing this for months. I can't sleep. It's just... And this is... anyway, first I've got to say hello to everybody. I'm Gordon, yeah? I'm the lovely father of the fantastically, fantastically lovely Jenna. I mean, Christ, the lovely bride. Anyway, I welcome you all here to join in the celebration of Jenna and Stuart's marriage. You've all made a great effort, having travelled from all over the world. I know it's not been easy, but I can assure you we very much appreciate you coming for this special day. And what a special day. I didn't think that I'd ever live to see it. Yeah. I'm talking about Stuart buying a drink. Once you're married, you only ever have to say, "Yes, dear." I think Stuart knows that already, eh? Yeah. I have fond memories of Jenna when she was very young. I used to lift her onto my shoulders. Hold on a minute, let's have a drop of gin. No, it's terrible. I used to lift her onto my shoulders and hold her by the ankles. And I used to... Do you remember that? And I imagine most all you young girls, your fathers did the same thing. Yeah? And, however, it was only last week I found out that Stuart's been doing the same for the last 12 years. I'm so proud of Jenna. I mean, not only absolutely stunning, you're beautiful. Amazing. Cheers. I've known Stuart since he was 16, and he's always been a real lovely lad, a real credit to his mum and dad, Carol and Ken. I've got to say, he's a fantastic lad. That's true.
So when Stu first asked me to be best man, it was actually over the phone. Would you believe it? Mr. Casual. I'm surprised he's even wearing shoes. Nevertheless, I was delighted, of course, and I said yes. I was, however, convinced that I may have been second choice, possibly to Moody. put me out my misery mood. Now, on a serious note, I was well up for the job. The most important job, of course, which was the stag do, not this speech. The stag do went great, for anyone who's concerned or interested. For anyone who doesn't know, we went to sunny Liverpool. We had a cracking time. A wonderful sight was Stuart wearing a dress. Yeah, he wore a couple, in fact, and he was far too comfortable wearing that dress, I must say. You also have to start questioning things when your best mate's got a better arse than any girl in Liverpool. Now, Stu did do a hell of a lot of shots on his stag do, it's fair to say. But he is here, so it's all good. Now, the main reason for so many shots is actually... I've got something here. Yeah. He's due to these. Got a good picture of Stuart on the front there. Yeah. Now, you won't believe it, but this is actually my genuine shoot the stag card from the stag do. And I never used it. Now, the good thing about being best man is you get to make up the rules. So this is no longer a shoot the stag card, it's a shoot the bride and groom card. So, a couple of shots coming over there.
Cheers.
Another thing he's great at, fantastic at him, thanks. In fact, he's being mistaken. He often gets mistaken, yep. He often gets mistaken for Bombhead out of Hollyoaks. Yep, that happens. Sometimes he gets mistaken for a 16-year-old Scandinavian boy. Neither of these are good for me, mind, because he far too often gets mistaken for my boyfriend. But above all these things, Stuart's best at being a friend. Not only to me, but to many others here. And he's always there when I need him. And he's always at the end of the phone for one of our long gossip sessions that Jenna frequently winds us up about, you know, how we natter for longer than most women. Obviously the sign of a good friendship. Now, I've also known Jenna for many years, but over the more recent years, I'd say, after being on many holidays and copious meals, I'd say we've formed a friendship of our own, which is really nice. I just hope she feels the same. It's fair to say Stu has done really well for himself in Jenna. I really can't see why he would marry her. Not only is she beautiful, but she's a real good laugh and doesn't take herself too serious. Yeah. Unless it involves Stuart, of course. Yep. But that don't count, because he is hard work, so we'll look. I'm pretty sure she can cook as well, so that helps. I'd have to say one of the most amusing things about Jenna for me is that funny little dance she does when she's drunk. Anyone seen it? You seen it? I'm sure that'll come out later. I'm just interested to see who she gets it off of. My money's over here. Jenna, I'd also have to say you've done really well for yourself marrying Stu. He is hard work, we can't deny that. But he is a real good chap. Very kind-hearted and generous. Plus, he does all the necessary building work around the house, which is very handy. Now, I'm not going to go on too much longer, but for the rest of the speech, I wanted to tell a story about Stuart. So where do I start? I've got a lot. But this particular story, I only learnt myself just recently. Now, Jenna was telling me this story just recently. And when she told me, I nearly spat my tea out. Yep. So I had to tell it today, basically. I might also add that it's carved a quite disturbing memory, image, shall I say, in my mind, and it keeps reoccurring. So I just, all I can hope for is that it happens to you a lot today. So it goes like this. Somewhat 10 years ago, I think. So oh, 10 years God. Ago, Jen?
Yeah.
Ish. So Stu takes Jen on a casual trip to the cinema. We all do that.
Oh my goodness.
It's pretty normal. What did you see, Jen? Can you remember that far back?
I can't remember.
No. So Stu and Jen, when you go to the cinema, they bought some popcorn, as you do. Very normal. Now, the point in which it become a little bit weird, and I never knew anyone done this. I thought it was
story. I didn't do anything.
He told me to do this.
Stuart mischievously, and I'll be careful how I word the next bit, decided to enter the popcorn. from underneath, not using his hands. It's pretty obvious what happened next. Let's be honest. Now, is everyone on the same page? Is everyone? Yeah, yeah. So Jenna got quite a fright, I would imagine.
She liked it.
And she ain't touched popcorn since. Or have you? Now, by my standards, this only leaves two questions. The first one's for Jenna. Was it salted or sweet popcorn?
Is that a good answer?
Fire away.
I like
meat. I think she said it started off sweet, but it ended up salty. Second question's for Stu. How did it feel? Right, that's enough from me. All that leaves is for me to ask you all to stand up and raise your glasses. And raise a toast to my best mate and his beautiful wife, Stuart and Jenna.
Linda, my mum, please come over and take.
Nice one, mate.
Thank you all for helping everything you've done.
Well, Tom. They say you don't marry someone you can live with, you marry the person you can't live without. And I think that sums us up perfectly. Jenna knows and understands me like no one else. She's managed to suffer living with me for the last 7 years. Home with a perfect team, She gives me orders and I'll take them. I first met Jenna, it was at the King's Oak pub in High Beach one summer's day. I remember she was fresh from holiday and she was all brown and freckly. She was obviously attracted by my spiky gelled hair and skinny pasty complexion. And after that, I think I wooed her doing wheelies on my moped while she stood and observed eating her hot wings at Chicken Up Lounge. I've always loved her dress sense as well. She's known as really trendy these days, but back then it was more like Gap fleece hoodie, Adidas tracksuit bottoms, and Nike Airs. But we've basically grown up together, and although it sounds cliche, Jenna's my very best friend. She's fiercely loyal, she's kind, she's very independent, and she's always thinking of others and will put others first. She's fantastically organised, which is great, as I'm pretty useless. She's helped me to be more confident in myself and my abilities. She's taught me that love for food goes well beyond being hungry. And I know I made you wait a while, but I'm pleased you stayed patient, and thanks for saying yes to marrying me. I know it's the start of many happy years together, and I love you.